Can you tell me where the bus is to get off Gooch Street? Gooch Street, Gooch Street. You guys aren't singing the harmonies right. Gooch, 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 Gooch Street, Gooch Street, Gooch Street, Gooch Street. That's not a frickin' harmony, that's a calamity. What do we got? A J. Tercer acoustic bass thing. And I got up this morning and I thought, it's raining, I'm gonna get a lot done. I'll take on the easiest job, okay? And this, the bridge had fallen off the guitar. And, the reason is they just glued the bridge to the finish, and then two tiny little winky screws, getting those inlays out of there was, two little dots covering the screws was hell, but I did it. So now, let's clean all that off and glue it back on properly, wood touching wood. So first I had to dig out the inlays, get the screws out of there. Then I came to realize I have to release the pickup in order to get a clamp in the right spot, which is there. Well, what I wanted to do was release that altogether so that I can just hold this in my hand. But inside the guitar, there are two cable tie mounts that they've used. And what you would do is you would put the cable tie on the mount and then go inside the guitar and go stick. Well, I don't want to peel those off. And for me to try and articulate a set of cutters inside the guitar, even with a mirror, I gave up. I'm just going to deal with it this way. And I'm going to be using my high-speed orbiting oscillating tool with the sanding attachment, and that'll just peel that off in about 2 seconds. What I'm sanding off is the actual finish that came off the top of the guitar when this let go, because they glued to the finish. That's what this is. This is all finish. Well, I'm starting to see brown dust. I think I got all the glue off. Or the top, or the finish, or whatever's on there. For the body, not quite as simple, but we'll get it. I would never do this on a wood-to-wood connection, but on a re-glue, I take a razor blade and scratch, just kind of score the top and the bridge. That way, when I clamp it, the glue is going to definitely get into the wood on both sides. So I got those two little screws just peeking out the back so that I get the exact position it was in before. Or using LePage wood glue. Pro. Okay, not small, pro. Quantity of Q-tips, some paper towel, which I'll get, some water. Clamps are standing by. I've already tested and rehearsed my clamps. I think we're about ready.
I'm ready.
And in a second, take a Q-tip, wiggle that shit around a bit, because it's going to squeeze everywhere. I don't like to put the glue too close to the edge, because that's where it's going to pop out here in a second. That should be it for that. Is that the spot?
that's where those screws bite in, I believe. That's it. Okay, clamp, clamp. Number one. Try and get three clamps on this. Hopefully. A little pad for that. That's one. Where did the other one go? Come on, you can do it, David. Another one of those guys. See a little glue squeeze out yet? A little bit, yeah. Here it comes. I'm not going to sink those screws back in until I get this clamp, which reminds me, I want to leave that screw exposed. I don't know if I can get the third clamp in there. You can do it, David. I'll be back. My phone's going off like 100 people. Okay, now I'm going to sink those screws back in to the top, like they ever really did anything. That's sort of that. Let's let glue dry. I don't have strings for it, so I'll be back later.
Well, there's not a lot of choices for strings. There they are. Let's get them on this thing and get it out of my house. The reason I'm still suffering short-term memory loss, it's been a couple days, but anyway, remember I released the pickup so I could, and I couldn't, didn't want to, but I did unplug it from the preamp to give me some length to work. Well, I put it all together and plugged it in, and oh no, the electronics don't work. I forgot to plug the thing back in. It's fine. It's tuned up. Let's set the truss rod, and it looks like it's going to play really good. It did have this really big shim under the bridge saddle that I removed, and I think it's a lot better. We'll see what happens.
I had an acoustic bass, what was it? Oh, a Kramer Farrington. And, yeah. So, the neck on this guy is, way, way tight. Way, way too straight. The thing about these, for me, is, it's like, unless you plug it in, this never keeps up with an acoustic guitar. So your hopes of playing around the campfire are dashed. Oh, let's find a wrench. Well, the truss rod works really nice. And it didn't take much. Like I said, unless you plug these things in, right? It's like... whatever. Goodbye. What is this thing? Does it even have a model number? It doesn't. J. Terser. Acoustic bass shaped thing object. All the wonderful links to things are below in the description. And, get a sticker. Don't forget to send me your address. Don't forget it's US dollars. Penny Black CD. Oh, coming up. Wow, I don't know who could make it or who would be able to. If you can, it'd be great. September 3rd, which is a Saturday on the Labor Day weekend. My good friend Russ, lead singer from the Killer Dwarfs, is going to be opening up for the amazing Mr. Pat Travers at the Rock Pile here in Toronto, the Rockpile Club. So what's kind of cool about that is in Russ's solo project band that he has, they do a few Penny Black tunes. Imagine that. So it's a little, it's pretty cool and slightly surreal to stand in the audience in a large crowd of people and watch a band play songs you wrote. Anyway, September 3rd, I will definitely be there. Like I said, all the great links to things are below. Any sort of support at this point for me is welcome at my age. What else is there? Nothing. Be good to each other. Cheers.